What is going on, everybody? Crazy Man here, bringing you guys another 1v1. Today we have a special game against Texcalibur. He is spawning here in the bottom position, playing as the apothecary, and we have yours truly spawning in as the war boss on the map called Durst Refinery. I like this map, but I always seem to play Tex on it, and that's not a good thing. So, this was a good match I had a couple days ago against Tex. It was super late at night, but I don't want to use that as an excuse for my play. And I'm not gonna lie to you. It's pretty good in the beginning, actually. We get off to a really good start. Immediately right out of the gate, you see Tex going for this wreck point here. As I randomed, I know he picked Space Marines. I didn't know he would pick the apothecary, but then again, I should have just assumed that he was gonna be the apothecary, because that's the guy he plays. As you can see, Warboss right here gonna get off to the nice start, picking off a single person, single model in that scout squad. And this is one of a few games I watched. Actually, this is one of two. The other game I watched was against Naria, which I may upload, because that was going to be awesome. Or that was awesome. That was an awesome game to watch. He's playing, Naria was playing as Nids, and Tex was playing as Chaos Sorcerer. But you can see the apothecary. He's probably the best support commander in the game, arguably. I would throw in there that the Commissar Lord is very good as well. Although I don't know if the Commissar Lord is as good, simply because the Apothecary has the raw ability to just heal people. As here you can see the Apothecary in a bit of trouble here. Looks like he may actually go down, and yes he does. So able to pick off the Apothecary. And back over here, these Tactical Space Marines. Gonna be forced to fall back. However, second Tac squad coming in, trying to kite these guys around, and this war boss is going to be easily kited here against these two tactical space marines. And there goes the special attack. I hate when he does that special attack and completely misses, but able to pick off another model of the scout squad right there. Continuing to kite, however, these guys don't have the range damage to go toe to toe with the tactical space marines. There was a bit of lag in the game. Apparently it was me. I don't know. I had Pandora open, so I was rocking out to my tunes, which is what I occasionally do. But I'll try to get you guys some more live comms. But those are not easy to come by. And a third Tactical Space Marine squad on the way. I struggle against Tactical Space Marines. Bad. Really bad. I don't know why. I just struggle against them. They're tanky unit. It's the same thing with me struggling against strike squads. Just not good against them. Don't like going up against them, especially when Tex is playing, and especially when he's using the apothecary. Like I said, is a really, really good support. It has the ability to heal right out of the gate. Also has a bunch of war gear options that are catered towards healing as well. So he's difficult to combat, and here I actually make a big mistake right there, losing the sluggas. It's the beginning of the downfall here, is just struggled losing models and squads and units throughout this game. However, I have a start 100-point lead here, so got the triple power. He doesn't actually have any power at all. No power nodes up yet. Obviously, he's wreck drained. Only has 207 rec income, so not a whole lot of requisition income from Tex, but these Tactical Space Marine squads will give him a lot of dominance here in this early to mid game. And should he get tier 2, obviously, even in the mid to late game, as they're just, they got their, they're versatile. I mean, they're one of the most versatile units, if not the most versatile unit in the game. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. They have the good flamers, which is good AoE. Light infantry, have plasma guns, they have the sergeants, they're decent in melee, they now have stern guard, which allows them to pretty much switch between those on the fly, and they're just just a tough matchup to go up against in general. As you can see, Tex reclaiming some territory over here with the Apothecary. Did he get him revved up. Still really low on requisition. However, he actually just obviously revived his commander. Since this is a 1v1, can't team revive. But Warboss getting focused down here. Gonna be forced to retreat as there goes the stomp. Flamers doing work against the Sluggas. And getting some looters out. This is something I should have done way earlier due to the fact that he didn't actually have any suppression counter at all. But going tier 2 now, this is what you gotta do against plays like this. I actually noticed that the Ludas have a cloak instantly, so I did not know that. Able to pick off a model right there, however it's not in the Flamer squad. As here goes the suppression team getting set up. Unfortunately, they're in the wrong position. And they're going to be forced to retreat. So this is where things start to go really, really bad. I'm getting forced back. And the three tactical space marines, like I said, this is where they really take over and really start to kick in. Got to get that tier 2 upgrade out as soon as possible. And if I'm able to get that out, would be looking a little better. However, there goes the knockback. And it looks like I'm going to be able to pick out this scout squad here. And yes, they down go. The Apothecary is in another tight situation there, and it looks like he may go down as well. Slugger Boys doing their best to pick him off. Slugger Boys go down, but so does the Apothecary as well, so I guess it's an okay trade, but regardless, still don't like losing models nonetheless, as these Tactical Space Marines are now suppressed. And that's going to be a bunch of splash damage. Not splash damage, but lots of damage on those units. As the Tactical Space Marines over here taking a bunch of damage here, they're going to be forced to retreat. However, they actually do lose another model. So they're down to just one. Tactical Space Marines going to be forced to fall back here a bit as well, down to about 500 HP. And they will be forced off. I'm surprised we actually haven't had a full-on retreat. There is a revive from the Apothecary, though, and Tech's still not 2-2, although he does almost have enough resources for it, so yeah, getting the heal off, and that's going to keep these guys in the fight a little bit longer there. He's now got his tier 2 upgrade started, and still enjoying about a 100-point lead, although there's a very fine line between enjoying a lead and in the actual game, and enjoying a lead. There's two different states of the game. It's the mental state where it looks like I'm just getting, feels like I'm getting wrecked in the game, and yeah, it just did not feel good in game. Get that player sense, if you will. But I'd love to do some live comms on this, but he gets on super late. However, I may have some games, not to mention in addition to that, we also have The Company of Heroes 2 beta coming out. Closed beta coming out. Tuesday. And today is Saturday. Tomorrow's obviously Easter, so I may get a video out then, but I'm not sure. I don't know. I may just enjoy Easter in general, but I do have the Sergeant on the way. Still Flamers rocking on those guys as well. Going around looking to do a little bit more power rating there. Is it still got the Ludas cloaked in the middle of the map? And now we do have someone's rearming. Nope. These guys are, and they're getting their missile launchers. Trying to hang out here a bit. Ludas are cloaked, and these are getting drawn in. There goes the decloak, and that's going to be a lot of suppression. Pretty decent amount of damage as well, considering the distance in relation to the suppression team. As this Apothecary taking a considerable amount of damage as well. He's also suppressed, and no longer actually is he suppressed, but he may actually go down here as he's down to 50, down under 30, 20, 10, got him. Able to pick off the Apothecary right there, so a pretty big victory there. However, these Tactical Space Marines doing what they do, power raiding for days. Tried doing that with these Slugger boys, however, it didn't actually work out. But Slugger boys, highly underused for power raiding. They're a very good unit for doing that. That missile just slams into the rock. Warboss sitting at level 2. As these shooter boys... What the hell kind of pathing was that? Very confusing. But this tech squad going ahead and grabbing their sergeant. Look at that sergeant, man. Gonna be forced back on those units. With those units from the Death Dread as the tactical Space Marine squad at the missile launchers are they're kind of over here capping some requisition points, trying to gather his units together here. One of the things I would have done differently is definitely would have gone ahead and grabbed the burners, which add I think they add about 400 HP or something ridiculous. It's pretty good, as these guys are now tied up in melee. There goes a big knockback, and that's going to force these units back. So the Death Dread able to hold on there. Cloaked looters, you want to try and mix up their positions a bit. We do have the combat stimulus equipment. Stern Guard Veteran Squad is out for attacks. So he's got his Flamer Squad, he's got his Missile Launcher Squad, and now he's got the Stern Guard. A pretty scary combination. In fact, that's a really scary combination. Going ahead and grabbing the Hellfire Rounds, I believe they're called. Like I said, I never grabbed these guys. So... Death Dread charging in here. This thing takes a lot of damage from these infantry, as they do have the ability to toggle, as I mentioned, between several different types of rounds. However, trying to grab at least a model kill here. Meanwhile, over here with the Sluggers, doing a little bit of power raiding, whatever it can. And there goes special attack. However, at this point, this Death Dread is pretty much doomed, as there is no way it is going to be able to escape. Also grab the improved medical equipment on the apothecary. Meanwhile, a complete power raid happened down here with the Slugger boys, so that's going to give them some nice experience in addition to denying him some resources as well. And Luda's in a kind of a bad position. I expected him to actually run down this flank with some units, but instead he actually came up and flanked from behind. So trying to activate the cloak in a desperate attempt to keep these units tied up in suppression and melee. However, these guys, I always forget to uncloak them, and by the time I actually had time to forget, I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. Suppression going down. Actually, no suppression just as of yet. These loot is going to be forced to retreat. As, not looking good at this point, however, still trying to maintain a flanking maneuver. Do have the Sanguine Chainsword on that unit, and here comes the missile launchers. Oh, get out! Trying to pull some jukes at the Death Dread. It's pretty difficult to do. As trying to get the tied up. Do have I'm on a double cap. Meanwhile, just going to be able to get some nice splash damage in there before the thing dies, so able to do pretty good damage right there. Actually, not a bad way to loot, not a bad way to go, but Slugger boys accidentally have them toggled on range, and they're going to be forced to retreat. That splash damage, Hellfire Rounds doing so much damage as the Storm boys are coming out. We do have a drop pod on the way, just going to allow him to even more easily reinforce and apply more pressure with this. Actually went ahead and grabbed the Mastercrafted Bolter. I thought that's what he had done, but going ahead and chilling with the Ludas up here on the high ground, trying to bait him into it. However, he splits his units up, and that's not a good engagement at all. Stern Guard is now level 2. Tactical Space Marines with the Flamers level 3, Apothecary level 3, and where's your last squad? Missile Launcher Tacks are level 3 as well, nearly level 4. Stern Guard able to get their heals off as well. is trying to go ahead and around and pick up any additional hits over here on these tactical space marines, who are taking a considerable amount of damage. However, their special attacks from their sergeant doing a bunch of knockback right there, and unfortunately unable to kill a single model in that squad. However, they are down to 600 HP, but they will be able to make it out A-okay. As moving the looters into a different position, Tex is now just floating a bunch of resources. As he's even just winning with this unit combination that he's got going on right now. Looters over here doing everything they can against tactical space marines. However, they're not very good against them. As the Storm Boy is going to be forced to fall back here. Stern Guard squad in combination with the Apothecary. Just too many heals. And too much good support from the Apothecary, who does, in fact. He deals a nice amount of DPS. But apparently a sergeant went down. I don't know. They are now level 3. As tier 3 is coming from Tex. Actually, a really close game on the score, but only 8 points separating. However, in battle, it's just totally different. As, got the units moving out. Regrouping and trying to capture. However, he's still got all three of it, reinforced all three of his power nodes there. Only have one generator up there. Not to mention, also have a node up there. It's saying I'm power starved. That's actually not the case. I'm rec starved. Thank you. There you go. He corrected himself. as this Apothecary kind of getting caught out here in a bad position. Gonna take a bunch of damage there. As the jump going on this Tactical Space Marine squad. Gonna use the aim and what stat to suppress these units as well. Looking to tie them up. And they're gonna take a bunch of damage here. No law. Actually, I'm able to pick off one there right at the end. As here come the Stern. Charging right into the Stern Guard, trying to do everything they can. These guys, while they are very tanky, need to be careful with them regardless. And they are going to take a bunch of damage there, down to 500, down under 400, down under 300 at this point, and actually down to 250. As now the Tactical Space Marine squad able to get their stim packs up, however, they're not before they lost a model already. And have good engagement, able to do a bunch of damage to the Stern Guard, unfortunately unable to kill them, as that would have... It would have helped out considerably. But Tex going ahead and saving it for a Land Raider. Unless you were to go ahead and crank out some Termies, which would just be fantastic. Stimpak going down there from the Apothecary on these Tactical Space Marines. Obviously, that Apothecary picking up his 5th level at this point. Warboss sitting at level 3. Still doesn't have any war gear on him, though. One of the things I could have done differently in this game would definitely have grabbed some different war gear options. I've been playing around with his war gear options lately, and well, he's got some pretty good... One of the things that actually I would have done here was actually grab his... I don't know, I don't remember the name of it. It's like a little... It's the first option in his accessory, and it allows him to charge. That would have been fantastic. As... It's just a huge disruption against all of these tactic squads. Knocking them back, allow my infantry to get in melee. As there goes the jump, however, those Hellfire rounds almost immediately carving up the Slugger Boys. And not a good fight at all. Not enough damage, and not enough support, actually. As the Land Raider is on the way, however... Looks like the Storm Boys will make it out without losing a single guy, so that's always good. Is the War Boss over here? They're coming. Get out. Level 4 Tactical Space Marines for both of them, sitting at 1,929 HP, so they are tanky, tanky units already. And when they get levels, they are even tankier. unable to pick off a model there. So you're sitting at about 500 HP. Meanwhile, the Warboss is going to be forced to retreat. Picking up the cyborg implants just to give him a little bit of tankiness. However, it doesn't. This is pretty much a waste of money at that point, as Tex able to pick off the sergeant there, actually. Did not know that I'd done that. But regardless, just the levels catching up. The level 3 shooter boys, level 2 shooter boys here, level 2 Ludas, actually, so may use them in future games. But the Land Raider is out. The Land Raider Redeemer, it's going green. As Hellfire rounds, that splash damage is just, it hurts. It hurts. But regardless, moving on over with the Flamers and the Apothecary. His support with the Stern Guards and the Tax was really, really good. He was able to pretty much just fight off any early pushes I had, able to hold off the vehicle that I had gotten in Tier 2, and, well, that pretty much was the game, but still doing a little power rating. As a Land Raider can just camp in the middle of the map. Do have a decent amount of resources built up, but it would require a perfect rock deployment to even deal pretty much half damage to the thing, so there goes the jump from the Storm Boys. Slugger Boys getting in there as well, tying up the Stern Guard in melee. However, here come the rest of the Tactical Space Marines, and that's pretty much going to be GG. Land Raider can just sit in the middle of the map and wait it out. GG is called! So one of the things that I would have done differently in this game, definitely not to lose as many Slugger Boys. The Slugger Boys were critical, were key losses for me. In addition, I would have gotten Ludas sooner, because he obviously didn't build an assault squad. And yeah, however, the commander score was pretty nice. I enjoyed the win in the commander score, getting those early kills on the Apothecary. However, them kept reviving him, which obviously delayed his tier 2 and delayed some of the upgrades on his units. But the unit score was where things were decided. And I was always questioning, what 4 units did he kill? Because I only lost 73, and he killed 77. I don't know. But the resource score was fairly even, both very high power rating going on throughout the game. However, Tex obviously built more power, lost one more power. It was about 2. Actually, only outgained me in that department, in the requisition department, by about 175. And the point score, he obviously was able to win that. Constantly using his Tactical Space Marines to flank around the scouts when he had them alive, going across the map and taking requisition points left and right, which ended up draining me. But I hope you guys enjoyed. This was a fun game against Tex. Hopefully the next time I play against him, I'll do some live comps or something. I don't know. We'll see. I'll see you guys later. Have a nice day. I'm out. Peace.